Perfect.
Pogo 2?
Yep, Pogo 2.
Hundreds of them?
Thousands of them.
So this is Vincent Medlin. Medlin. What interest are you going on here?
This one is Yannick Bestemann's old boat.
Okay, this is the one which beat your dad's boat.
Yes.
The answer is yes.
Yes.
The answer is yes, basically. He told me it was. Yeah. So, I mean, you're second generation mini sailor. How does this sort of feel? Because you've kind of lived and breathed it. Because you must have been down here when your dad was doing it, when you were.
Yeah, so I was in La Rochelle when he started and certainly saw the buzz and the boats were always just awesome. But actually, as I was growing up, at that point, I never really wanted to do the mini. It was my dad's thing. I was like, oh, I'll never do it. It's his dream. It's his race. And then suddenly I started doing double-handed solo. And then it was like, actually, what's this? Yeah. That mini looks awesome. Let's go back to that.
Yeah, it's just this long old process of turning into your father, isn't it?
Yeah. Mm. I mean, you try and deny it and then put family together.
Another feeling. Hey, what have we got here? What's this one?
So that's in a Sierra.
Okay, so another one of these really powerful.
So that's a Swiss boat now. And it was Swiss last time. So it's just Justine Metro's old boat. Who finished second in the last transit.
Yeah.
In the series class.
Good. And that's pretty, I mean, that properly looks like a sort of 40 footer with, which has been sort of chopped off, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Pogo 2, I'm guessing. Yeah. So I'm getting good at this.
So this is one of the new offset boats.
Okay, right, this is the first one we've seen.
It's probably one of my favourites.
Right, so he's one of the race boats in the series class.
Yep.
So this is an Etienne Bertrand design.
Exactly, yeah. So they've been built down in La Rochelle.
Okay.
In a small little yard down there. So they just became series.
Okay, and do you not need 5 to be a series?
To become a series, you need 10 boats.
You need to build 10 boats.
10 boats need to be built, and 3 need to have qualified, so done the 2,000 miles. And the boat needs to have done 2,000 miles as well above that.
Okay, so I'll probably try and get some pictures. But you just see an idea of the volume in the bow there. It's got an unusual sort of double chine thing going. Double chine? Is that good? Why would you have double chine? So the one better than single chine?
Extra stability, I guess.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
They're very large, fat bow.
Enormous, yeah, I mean, it's not quite as fat as the protos, but it's still sort of a ton of buoyancy out there.
Yeah.
And does anything, I mean, I'll kind of have another, have you been on board one?
Yeah, we've actually had 19 people on board.
19?
It's a bit of a challenge. And it was only 19 because that was how many people were around. We probably could have got more.
Yeah, that's the cockpit. That's cool. Good, and what have we got here?
That's another Pogo 2.
Yeah, another Pogo 2. Oh, and it's starting to rain, awesome.
Press it off, yeah.
Right, am I going to record and not press the button? Which button do I not press?
No, it's recording now. What's this one?
Yeah, no, but this is Lombard, my dad's old boy.
Okay, right, so this is
Sam Keita.
Yeah, another epic boat. Yeah, it's funny, isn't it? You just look at the transom and see how different the hull shapes are.
Yeah, it's very, very, very rounded size, yeah.
Yeah.
But still very fast. So this one finished 5th in the last transat.
Yeah. The RG650.
That's the RG650, yeah. So that's Yuri will explain to you about the
Yuri, hello.
RG650.
Can you just tell us a bit about this boat?
Yeah.
So this is the only
kind of information you need.
You've obviously got there are a number of quite interesting series boats in this race. Uh-huh. How do you reckon this boat will compare?
Yeah, it's a series boat, RG650. I built this boat in Argentina 2 years ago for qualifier Mini Transat race. It's a designer of this boat, Nicholas Goldenberg, maybe do you know him, maybe no. And, he's a young designer, but I believe him, and we can see what he do it actually after we finish in the last road.
And where are you from?
I'm from Moscow, I'm Russian. Yeah.
And you're the first Russian mini sailor?
Yes, I am. Actually, yes. Nobody tries sailing in this class. I'm first and I'm happy because if you're first, every time you're happy.
How did you hear about the mini class?
Mini is a really interesting class. It's a lot of people sailing in this class and really stronger sailors I know. It's a lot of people preparation well, and I think it will be not so easy to be 10 part in the first 10 of part in this race. But I try to do it. Yeah.
So are you famous in Russia now? You're doing this? Are you famous in Russia now? You're doing this race?
No, I'm famous in Russia. Very many good sailors, and I'm just one sailor from the biggest country.
Brilliant. Well, we wish you the best of luck.
Sorry?
We wish you the best of luck.
Oh, yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah, I believe it.
Thank you. All right, let's move on. What Russian you're racing against? Poker 2, right. I feel as though I've sort of paid homage to the... really? The friend of yours, Nikki?
Yeah. Victor.
And what would this one be?
That's another offset.
Okay,
so... same as Lipinski's.
Okay, so Ian Lipinski's.
Yeah.
So they got that sort of wet look now.
Yeah.
Had a bit of a downpour. Yeah. Yes, you can sort of really see the chine. You can really sort of see the chine there. This is the double chine one, isn't it?
Yeah. We've got another Argo here. So this is
Tongi. Okay, this is Tongi the Turkman. And so this guy has won pretty much everything this year, from what I gather.
Pretty much, yeah. Certainly been fighting at the top. I think Transgascon is maybe third or fourth, but Pogo 3 is the opposite, so we're kind of pushing.
Yeah, so this guy, Tongi the Turkman, he's won the trophy map. He's won the Pornichet Select, he's won the Lorient Bretagne Sud Mini, and last year was second in the Sabdalone Resource in back.
Yeah.
Which is pretty, so I think he is actually leading the series class at the moment.
He certainly got the experience there. He did the last transit as well in 2013.
Oh, did he as well?
Finished in the
Pogo 2. Yeah, I see. So we should probably give him... So what's he got along the back here? Is that a spare something or other?
What's that?
What's the silver thing?
So the silver thing is a spare spinnaker pole.
Okay. So he definitely intends to finish.
Yeah.
So this is the boat which is currently leading the series class overall in the mini championship. It's very well sorted, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just like your boat. Grenier Capitaine. Is that significant?
What's that?
Grenier Capitaine, he's got on his boom.
I imagine it's grandparents.
Yeah, sure. Okay, and what's this one? This is the unusual.
That is a... I'm going to say tip top. But
it's got the chamfer on the...
Is it in all this?
It's a tip top, okay. But this is Samian Manyard design. But it's got the chamfer on the... hull deck join.
Yeah.
Moving on.
This is a D2.
We haven't had one of those yet, have we? A Dingo 2.
Dingo 2.
That's one of the unfortunately named series boats, isn't it? This is a Pierre Roland design?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So this is, what, a 5, 6, 7, 8-year-old design, something like that?
Probably even
older than that.
Yeah.
Okay, so
it's certainly very good upwind and light winds.
Okay, it's quite slab-sided and it's got quite a deep chine, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Actually, it's got quite a lot of freeboard. Is there a freeboard on the series?
Yeah, it's no less than 0.75.
Okay. So more than the Bretas?
I think it's the same for everyone. No one's allowed less than 0.75.
Yeah. So we've got some big old solar panels here. What are people using? What have you got for power in your boat?
For me, I've got a fuel cell.
A what? A fuel cell. Okay.
Is that
what most people have got these days?
Yeah, most people do. And those that don't have a fuel cell will have a petrol generator. Mm. And then pretty much everyone's got solar panels on top of that.
I see.
Got 150 watts of solar panels, so I could effectively run my boat off solar panels.
Yeah.
But I've got a fuel cell as a kind of backup.
Okay, right. But it's a question whether you have the solar panels up and running. Sort of permanently mounted.
Mine are flexible panels, so I'll keep them down below and then I'll just attach them with elastics to guardrails or the coach roof.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Just move around. Arguably, I could even attach them to the sails if I wanted to.
Hmm. Okay, so this is a Manyard design.
Yep, it's in this town, Estonia.
Estonia, right. That's cool, isn't it? He's done the race before, hasn't he?
He started the last one.
Yeah. That's good. I mean, yeah, Russian, Estonian. I
gather very mixed nationality.
15 nations, I gather. So.
Yeah, certainly I think 40 of them are French and the rest are all foreign, so it's just pretty high foreign. rate compared to previous years.
No, sure. And it's quite, of all the sort of French classes, it is by far the most cosmopolitan, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Because although sailing's never cheap, but it's certainly a cheap entry into semi-professional racing. It certainly attracts.
Did this boat used to be something special before, or has this, do you know, this sort of track record?
Yeah.
Yeah, there it is. Good, so moving on.
That'll be a Pogo 2 again.
That'll be another Pogo 2, yes. Good. And what's we got here?
The Proto design. So it's, which one.
It has that sort of Italian feel to it.
788, so it's the old
So basically all the minis have got bow numbers, and if you're cool like Nikki, you know all their bow numbers, and sort of you can open up a little file in your head and it'll tell you.
I've forgotten exactly, but
we're
Kelly Italian guy,
you can. Yeah, there's actually been, for some years now, there's been a fairly strong Italian presence on there.
Very much so, yeah.
The minis.
They've got their own class down there, and it's actually becoming more and more popular. Yeah. So if you come across Mark Anini, who's sailed the Class 40 before in the Global Ocean Race, he's set up a mini training centre down in Spezia.
They've got
about 30, 40 boats down there.
Oh, okay. Which is Gianni Soldini's near there somewhere as well.
Certainly be seeing more Italian boats.
Yeah, so what's this one? This is
another, another Proto.
That's like quite an old one. That, this one
614.
It's a Berry Rakupo, 2006 generation.
Yeah.
Yeah, the nice crinkling of paper.
He started the last transat as well. He finished it. Sort of with us last year.
Yeah, you can also tell the generation of boats, both in this class and in the Mockers, by the angle of the dagger board. So if they're sort of pointing inwards towards the mast when they come out there. Is it all the generation?
So he's got a nice new mast because unfortunately he masted earlier in the year.
Oh, did he? Okay. What's this one?
So this is the new Pogo 3.
Oh, okay, so we haven't seen this one either.
The newest Pogo 3, actually.
Even better. So this is a Guillaume Verdier design. Pogo was, there was a Pogo 1 and then the Pogo 2, which were basically the most popular kind of series boats in the Mini Transat over the last 20 years or so.
Pogo 2 has pretty much dominated the production.
Yeah.
I think it was launched in 2003. So they've just launched the Pogo 3 this August last year.
Oh, so it's about a year old.
Only just became series because obviously all the boats they've got to build 10. Yeah. So it literally only became series this summer.
Yeah. Cool.
So they've been racing in the Proto fleet for the season.
Yeah.
Testing the sequel arm next one.
So who's this? Oh,
it's
right.
Pogo 2. Just testing the sequel
arm. Okay. Have you got a big sleeper arm?
I have indeed, yep.
Right, so.
Nasira.
Oh, this is another Nasira. Okay, we'll go along this bit of the dock first. So another Proto here for the kick flip up brothers this time.
This is another Mamod, 759, Romain Michel, French, but has lived in England actually for most of his life.
Really?
Working out at a farm now as a professional skipper.
Right, professional skipper.
So that's Jeff McFarlane's boat from the last transit.
So that one there?
Yeah, which dismasted and I think got written off as well, but there's been redone and he's now back racing now, very, very fast boat.
Yeah. Cool. And this is how they used to look.
So this is the Fino, the winner of the last transat.
The last transat?
Yep.
So this is
Benoit Murray's boat from the last transat.
Okay.
Ludovic Michelin, who did the last transat as well, and one of the oldest boats, 007, last transat.
Yeah. So this is the winning boat from last time, which you would imagine it means it's got pretty good pedigree this time.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So yeah. And certainly Ludovic's got those points. Right.
Hello.
Hello. Cool. And there's another Nasira, I'm thinking. Nasira?
Yes.
You see? Perfect.
David working away down below, who's the token electrician for the mini fleet.
How is he?
Work any hour of the day.
Perfect. Cool, day or night.
Yeah.
Yeah, really powerful sections there, isn't it? This one?
That is another D2, I believe.
Alright. Okay.
So this is a zero.
So which one?
A zero, so a Lombard design series.
Oh, okay, so that's the original.
So it's effectively the prototype, the series, the Sub-Kita 240, mm-hmm. It's a prototype version of the Zero.
Okay,
so they're
right.
Kind of the same generation.
Yeah, I see. Again, you can see the sort of how the hull shapes have developed. You know,
exactly.
Not
so
much, no
an absolute
channels.
Weapon in light winds, but quite unstable
yeah.
in heavy winds.
Yeah. Do you think this type of, obviously the course has changed for the Mini has gone back to going to the Caribbean. Do you think that's affected the design of the boats at all?
I think so, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So now it's much more of a sort of trade wind blast
trade
rather than.
Downwind, yeah.
There's no doldrums, there's yeah. none of that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Mm.
Okay. Cool. So, Sebastian, what's in the ear? Tip top, so you can tell from the camper.
Yeah, so, this is another original Fino.
Yeah.
Just before the Pogo 2, so I imagine some similar kind of hull shape, proto version, so perhaps
yeah.
the
and so he's got the Bottom Sea
yep,
hydrogenerator.
Yeah.
Are they getting more popular in the Mini fleet?
I think that's probably the only one in the fleet.
Yeah. Okay, so that would
not
be
so
a no then.
Yeah.
I imagine they did.
I don't think we reach significant speeds to make it worthwhile.
Oh, really? Okay. Oh, well, it looks like it's been sponsored by them. Okay, cool. And this one's got the, so this is another protest. This
pretty,
has got
yeah.
this has got the sort of boomerang kind of spreaders on it.
Another Pogo 2.
Pogo 2.
It's Portuguese, Antonio. Pardon? This is another Nasira, and this guy's actually come from the other side, so this summer he sailed across the Atlantic to get here.
Oh, really? So we've seen the front end of Nasira this summer?
He's been working towards it for a few years. He was
okay.
certainly one of the DCQ entries 2 years ago, but I don't think he came across to the end.
Mm.
So he's certainly done a lot of miles on his boat.
Yeah. Is there quite a sort of mini circuit in Italy?
In Italy? Initially, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
But he's come across from America.
Oh, sorry, has he right? Okay.
So he literally did a transatlantic June.
Wow, okay.
Did it here in time for the race, do one more race to qualify. Because
yeah, yeah.
crossing the Atlantic once wasn't enough, so he had to.
No, of course, well, why would it? Yeah.
Because you have to get the.
Get a bit of practice
you have to get your 1,000-mile race miles. Yeah. So what number
Pogo 2? Pogo 2, so this is a local boat from. Guadeloupe, I think. Carl Chipotel.
This is another Proto, 348,
yeah.
Magnin. So it's Renard Gerens boot from 2001.
Oh, really? So this is again quite old school, got a single dagger board in the
single
middle.
Single dagger board swim curl.
Yeah, no chines. So this is how they used to look.
They've just got carbon masts now. Because
yeah.
back before, carbon masts have only really been around since 2003, 2005.
Yeah, okay. Good, let's. So we're walking on the dock again. Sort of getting... So Pogo 2, yeah. Right. You can look back to our video from about 4 years ago, to talk where we talked about that. And opposite...
Pogo 3,
yeah. Oh, so this is Pogo 3, right? And we can actually
the first ever Pogo 3 built.
So okay,
number one out the mold.
That's cool.
Might be able to get you on board if you
No, I'll do that tomorrow, but let's just have a quick look at it. Again, I mean, it's got tumble.
Wow, lots of buoyancy.
It's actually got tumble home.
Out the water. Stern's completely out the water.
Yeah.
So it's a big banana. And you just can stack your weight and stabilise how you want.
Oh, really? That's the idea, isn't it?
And there's big buoyancy in the bow.
So this is not quite as beamy as the boat we're just about to see, but it's not far off. You see a massive beam on the waterline there. And somewhere down there I'm sure there's a chine. Very, very...
Quite low down chine.
Yeah. And big sort of boomerang spreaders there too. Increase the jib size. No, cool bit of kit, isn't it?
Yeah.
And they're quicker, they're pretty quick on the race course.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah. I'm sure a lot of it's in its kipper. Yeah. So you go a comparison here, so you've got Pogo 3 here, and
yeah.
Offset here. So these two will be fighting.
Yeah, so again you can get a better view of the the sort of bow thing that's going on. How attractive is that?
With Julian working away.
Yeah. Yeah, but not as attractive as the boat we're just about to see. Okay, so this is David Bodock.
David Bodock, the second scow.
Okay, so the first scow which won the protocast in the last race was the race before last, wasn't it?
Race before, yes.
Which was David Raisin's teamwork, which basically sort of set the trend for this delightful sort of bathtub shape, scow bowed. Mini, and in fact there haven't actually been that many more built since.
Is David? Not sure. So the most recent one.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we'll come back to it and say.
On board.
But, and this one has. Is there anything special about this one? This is just a further development.
It's the second generation of the original.
Yeah. Do you know how they've changed it all? That would be a question for them.
Slightly rounder. It's got chime on it, but the other one didn't.
Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah.
Don't know if the first one did, but this one certainly has a. Where the keel's been canted, yeah. It can also extend, so when it's in. When it's canted, you can make it longer to reach the 2 meter box.
Sure, okay. That's pretty cool, isn't it? Yeah.
Unfortunately, we can't see it, but the newest sailing posters.
Yeah,
well, as well as being able to extend the keel, he can also rotate it left and right, and his dangles are rotating.
And I gather he's had Mistej involved in his.
Yeah, so it's all Mistej kind of team designing it.
Yeah, I see.
Lovely, yeah.
So again, you've got a single spread on this boat, and it's sort of slightly boomeranged at the end.
Fully canting.
Canting mast?
Yeah.
How's that? Okay. So it's got quite a lot of rake on it as well.
Very much so, yeah.
Cool.
So there's virtually just a pin in the bottom of the mast, so you can just rotate it back and forward.
Great.